Hi, my name is Shirley Zelstra. I'm the Wildland Fire Chemicals Program Leader with the U.S. Forest Service. Today I wanted to talk a little bit about retardant and about what it does on wildland fires and how we deliver it to wildland fires. When we use retardant, when it's delivered to a fire, we load it onto airplanes. We call them air tankers. Air tankers typically carry between about 800 to 3,000 or 4,000 gallons. Some of them can carry more than that. The retardant as it's delivered to the fire is about 85% water, about 10% fertilizer, and that remaining 5% are minor ingredients like the color, thickeners, corrosion inhibitors, things like that. One of the unique aspects of the fire retardants are that the water that it contains is not what's actually slowing down or stopping the fire. The active ingredient in this product is the fertilizers. Those fertilizers are typically ammonium phosphate based. Because the ammonium phosphate or the fertilizer is the active ingredient, all of the water in that retardant can evaporate and we can still expect performance out of that product on the fire. There's an actual chemical reaction that goes on between the heat of the fire and that ammonium phosphate fertilizer. Essentially, what it's doing is the fire runs into the fire retardant line, that chemical reaction starts working, and it's pulling heat out of the fire. It's basically robbing the fire of its heat so it can't sustain itself and continue burning up the fuels. So I have a demonstration here that I'm going to show. I have two fuel beds here. One is treated with retardant and one is not. We have the same amount of fuel on both beds. And I'm going to burn them and just kind of show you how the fire moves through the retardant treated bed versus through the untreated fuel. This fuel that we're using is shredded aspen. We call it Excelsior. The retardant that we applied to this bed, we applied it about a week ago, week and a half ago, and so all of the water that was in here has evaporated, and you can see it's no longer wet. The main objective of the retardant is to decrease the intensity of the fire and to make it easier for the firefighters to get out there on the ground and do their work. It's a tool that they can use. It allows them to get closer to the fire if necessary to dig their fire lines. Sometimes the retardant will put the fire out, but that's more of a bonus. We're really using it as a way to retard the fire, to slow it down or to stop it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and burn both of these beds, and we'll just kind of see what some of the differences are between the fires in the two different fuel beds. So I'm going to light the treated bed first. We'll let that burn for a minute or two. So you'll notice this bed is smoldering. It's not burning real vigorously. There's a lot of smoldering going on with the treated bed. You'll notice a lot more smoke. That's one of the byproducts. Part of what we're seeing in that smoke is some of the residual steam from the fuel moisture. All fuel will retain a little bit of moisture as it's burning. One of the big things we notice with the two beds is the flame intensity and the flame height. You can tell with the untreated bed that the flame height is much higher. If you were a firefighter working on a fire line, you'd probably prefer working next to that retardant line as opposed to that untreated fuel. Notice the speed that the untreated bed is burning, that the fire is almost even with the fire that's burning in the treated bed, even though we started the treated bed maybe 45 seconds sooner. So again, the retardant is working by decreasing the intensity of the fire. We're robbing the fire of its heat so that it can't maintain itself, so that it can't continue burning the available fuel. The fire in the untreated bed has now moved past the flame front in the treated bed. The amount of retardant that we put on the treated bed is similar amount to what we would put on in the real world. It's about a coverage level 2 or 3 GPC, which stands for gallons per 100 square feet. So we don't have to use a lot of it to get quite a bit of results from it. And as I had mentioned earlier, you're noticing on the treated bed that the fire is still burning through there. It's still smoldering in there. It's just not burning as intensely. It's retarding the fire. It's not suppressing it necessarily. And then in the untreated bed, you can see we're almost to the end of the fuel. That fire is going to go out here in a little bit after it's burned up all the fuel. And we still have about a third of the treated bed remaining. It slowed the fire down that much. What we just saw there, where the fire kind of got knocked down and then it flared back up a little bit, that's not uncommon with the retardant lines. So the last point I wanted to make is you'll notice a difference between the two beds. The bed that was untreated is completely consumed. The treated bed, we still have this layer of kind of char or burned fuel. That's because the fire was burning cooler in this bed. We had incomplete combustion. If I tried to relight this again, it wouldn't relight. It's just demonstrating that the fire burned through there much, much less intensely than it did in the untreated bed. So that's long-term fire retardant. Thanks for your time.